Hi, and welcome to the Owatonna Today Show. I'm Shelley Whitehead. Thank you so much for joining us today. And we want to really thank those people who've made this show possible. These are our supporters, the people who've stepped up, companies, businesses, organizations, and said, you know, we like what you're doing, want to keep it going. So we'd like to start by thanking our premier supporters. They are City of Owatonna, Express Employment Professionals, Owatonna Public Utilities, Safe and Drug-Free Coalition of Steele County, United Way of Steele County, and the Walk to End Alzheimer's. Thank you to them. Also, thank you to our primary supporters. They're Amy Swain Hearing Centers and Little Theater of Owatonna. We wouldn't be here today if it weren't for our interlude supporters. Abraham Consulting Technologies, Bremer Bank, Brenda Bednar Mortgage Office, Glenn Meager and Tim Thomas of the Brick Meager Funeral Home and Medford Funeral Home, Brookdale Senior Living Center, Clarebridge and Sterling House, Carlson Branson & Company CPAs, ERA Gillespie Real Estate, Fairview Animal Medical Center, Horizon Eye Care Professionals, Glanter & Son Landscaping and Concrete, Napa Auto Service, Owatonna Business Incubator, Owatonna Foundation, Profinium Financial, R&K Electric, Snap Fitness, Steele County Historical Society, Steele County Transitional Housing, The Third Hand Incorporated Video Productions, and TPS Insurance. Each and every one of those businesses likes what we're doing right here on the Owatonna Today Show, and we'd like you to like them as well. All you have to do is go into their business, let them know that you heard them right here on the Owatonna Today Show, and then you can also be a part of this great team that we have. I'll give Leanne Alt a call at 390-5751, and she'll let you know all the details you need to be a part of the Owatonna Today team. Stay with us. We're going to be talking to the United Way as well as Express Professionals in just a moment. We'll see you right back.
Hi, I'm Jody Voisin with the staff at Fairview Animal Medical Center, your other family doctor. Fairview Animal Medical Center is a proud supporter of the Owatonna Today Show.
When using a fire extinguisher, we suggest using the pass system. Pull the pin at the top of the extinguisher that keeps the handle from being accidentally pressed. Aim the nozzle toward the base of the fire. Squeeze the handle to discharge the extinguisher. If you release the handle, the discharge will stop. Sweep the nozzle back and forth at the base of the fire. After the fire appears to be out, watch it carefully since it may reignite. If you have the slightest doubt about whether or not to fight the fire, get out and close the door behind you. This has been a safety message from the Owatonna Fire Department.
Hi, my name is Dave Olson and I'm with R&K Electric, where we provide power to the people. We're proud supporters of the Owatonna Today Show.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Olson of Mayo Clinic Health System in Owatonna. We know that good health goes beyond having a quality clinic and hospital in our community. That's why United Way is convening community partners to reduce obesity, diabetes, and heart disease in Steele County. At the same time, United Way is funding programs that increase access to health and dental care right now. We're proud to be a partner of the United Way Community Campaign Leadership Team, and we encourage you to join us by giving a gift this year.
And we're back with the Owatonna Today Show. You looking for a job? Wonder what it's like to look for a job? Maybe you don't need a job. You're lucky, because most of us do. And so we're going to talk to Tanya and Brian today a little bit about what it's like right now out there to try and find a job and maybe some opportunities for you to kind of figure out how to find that job. So first of all, let's introduce ourselves.
Sure. My name's Tanya Paley. I am the Director of Strategic Operations at the United Way. I have a new title. I've got a job. So, and my job actually is to talk about what the United Way is doing to reduce the barriers to people getting a good paying job, getting into the place that they need to be for themselves and their family. And so one of the things that we have done, we had a community conversation. We've talked on the show before about that. And as a result of that, we've put together some working groups and we have a strategic planning committee. And Brian Coleman, that's here with me, is on that strategic planning committee.
Yes.
And also helping to head up a work group with Jennifer Libby from the Owatonna Chamber of Commerce that's looking at how can we help to reduce those barriers to getting a good paying job. How can we address the workforce needs that are out there and help people be trained for the jobs that they would like to have and that will pay well. So that's that's the work that we wanted to talk about today. And before I launch it over to Brian, I just did want to talk about one program that we're doing like right this minute. So if you're listening, if you have a job offer that requires steel-toed boots and you don't have the money to pay for those boots, or sometimes employers do offer a way that they'll take it out of your paycheck if you've got a full-time job with an employer that you need boots for that job. But if, say, you're working for one of our temporary agencies and they give you an offer that you need to buy steel-toed boots, you can take that offer over to Salvation Army. They'll give you a referral slip. Mm-hmm. And then you take that to Owatonna Shoe, and they'll put you in some really nice steel-toed boots. And so we have actually put 100 people to work with these steel-toed boots.
Wow. People who would not have probably been able to get the job if it had
exactly.
not been for this
because,
program.
You know, we know those boots are not cheap.
They
and you
be.
Don't want to go and get a cheap pair of boots because that's not going to protect you. Mm-mm. So, yeah, we feel really good about that.
That's great.
Yeah.
Good.
So that's one thing we're doing, but there's lots more to do. So, yeah.
Brian, introduce yourself a little bit. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm Brian Coleman, Area Manager for Workforce Development, but I'm here today, you know, representing United Way and the Strategic Planning Committee, if you would, as well as, you know, to talk to the public about jobs, as well as to employers. You know, if I'm talking to a job seeker or an employer about it, I can talk about some of the resources that we have available at the Workforce Center. We are also one of those sites where a person can go for the Boost to Work program well. So we do have that information there. But, you know, when we're talking about employers and meeting the needs of the employers in today's economy, there seems to be a body shortage, if you would. A lot of jobs for not enough people to fill those jobs. Mm-hmm. And one of those things that we can do at the Workforce Center is to help individuals, you know, upgrade their skills, whether it be through training, through a post-secondary, or whether it be on-the-job training, which is also a benefit to the employers because we can reimburse their wages for their training period up to 12 weeks, you know, regardless of the area in which they're in. You know, it could be anyone from an executive down to a production person. So
with when you talk about the job worker shortage, because there's not a job shortage here in the area, are you looking at maybe jobs that are higher skilled jobs that are, or is it just kind of the whole gamut? You're just everywhere.
Well, it's all over the board, and I think that one of the things that we wanted to talk about through United Way is addressing those needs of the employers and seeing where they actually have those openings and what type of person are they looking for, what skill sets are they looking for, and then bringing that back to be able to try to fulfill their needs. That's been one of the situations that we've been dealing with, you know, for a couple months now. It's really picked up within the last couple months.
And we also were talking a little bit off air about people who maybe do have a job, but they aren't underemployed.
Correct.
And so with the job market the way it is today, there's a really good chance that if you are working a couple part-time jobs, that you might be able to go to one full-time job that is meeting the needs that you need financially.
Correct. You know, during the recession time, I believe that there was a lot of individuals that took jobs that they may not have taken, you know, in order to make ends meet and support their families. And I think during this time, they have the opportunity to go into a full-time position and not have to work two separate jobs. A lot of those jobs that they were working were more in the retail side too, so the hours are varying weekends and things like that. So they have the opportunity to get the shift that they were looking for and the wage that they were looking for without having to work two jobs.
And you know, if you are looking at making that transition, the great thing about working with your business is that you can give them the skills, the confidence even, to start applying for those positions.
Correct. Yeah. As well as, you know, just talking to them about, you know, what they really want to do. Mm. I think they haven't thought about that because of the fact that they've been trying to make it work. Mm. And now having the opportunity to kind of upgrade your skills and go in a direction that you really wanted to go, or go back into the workforce, maybe with the type of work you were doing before, having that opportunity now, it's vibrant and it's there.
So now's the time to do it. Mm-hmm. And you were talking to me also, Tanya, a little bit about you have a summit that you're working on developing with several different organizations. Tell me a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so at the same time, as we know, people need help right now to get into those jobs that Brian is talking about, or you know, the boots that we talked about. We also at the United Way, one of our themes right now is really trying to take a step back from the crisis and also address, you know, what are the jobs of the future, and have a conversation with our schools and our Riverland and others that do the training to say, okay, maybe you're not out in the workforce yet, maybe you're in 10th grade, you know, and how are we going to get you ready for the jobs of, you know, today and tomorrow? And so that conversation is a retreat that we're having. Brian is going to be helping to lead it, as well as myself and Jennifer Libby. And so if you're listening and you're interested in that conversation of, you know, schools, workforce, Chamber of Commerce, and other organizations like the United Way, getting involved with us, our goal is to actually put together an action plan of what are we going to do in the next couple of years to get our community to the place where we want it to be.
Are you looking for parents? Are you looking for employers? What are you really looking for in that
kind of group? I would say employers for sure.
Correct.
And schools. And then we were talking off air. I know you have Express coming on. So if you work for, you know, if you do placement for jobs, we also would like to have those folks here.
Because the more people you have to dialogue about it, the wider and the better the fix can be for that.
That's right. But we want it to be the people who are actually going to be then implementing the action plan. So parents will, we definitely want to talk to parents. We want them to know what we're doing. Mm-hmm. And there will be a role for them, but probably not at this particular stage.
Okay. Right. Just to, and this again is just to kind of what can we do to start preparing our kids for the coming, the workforce. Because not everyone's going to go to college.
Right.
Some of them will go to technical schools.
Yep.
Everyone's got a different life plan. You know, it's what
Absolutely.
They're good at.
It's just easing those transitions, in this case, from high school to employment. Or from high school to some kind of training to employment. Mm-hmm. And also then we have also looked at some other barriers that maybe adults would face in being able to get up to speed.
Good. Well, and you don't know the date for that yet, but you will have information about the summit on your website?
Yeah, if they're interested in attending, please call us at the United Way and we'll make sure to send you out an email with all the details and would love to have you.
And Brian, if they need more information at the Workforce Center, they can contact you there.
Yes.
It's, you're there, that's what you're there for.
Right.
You know, don't feel be afraid.
Open to the public.
Yeah.
You know,
Any,
everybody welcome. I think the biggest thing is that we did move. We are at the Riverland campus now.
Okay.
So we are out at the college, and we're excited to help anyone.
Yeah. So make sure you contact both of these lovely people if you want more information. And do stick with us. We're going to be talking with Express and continuing this conversation in a lovely way in just a minute. So stay with us.
Start a team. Join a team. Walk to end Alzheimer's. Visit alz.org/walk today.
Hi, my name is Dave Efforts with TPS Insurance. We're here to handle all your insurance needs. We are a very proud supporter of the Owatonna Today Show.
I didn't just want another job. I wanted a career. So I expressed myself.
I was new to town, and I didn't know where to turn for a job, so I decided to express myself.
I decided to express myself, and they helped find the right career for me.
Express Employment Professionals is in contact with thousands of companies in need of quality employees. Come in now and get the job you deserve.
Express yourself today.
Do you know how to safely dispose of your prescription and non-prescription drugs? Not by flushing them down the toilet or putting them in the garbage. Doing so pollutes our rivers, streams, and drinking water supply. Take it to the box instead for safe, secure disposal. It's easy. Bring your unused medications in their original containers to the drop-off locations listed on the screen and drop them in the Take It to the Box drop box. Proper disposal of unwanted medications keeps them out of the hands of children and out of our environment. This is a message from the Safe and Drug-Free Coalition of Steele County.
Hi, this is Doug Johnson at the Owatonna Business Incubator, a proud supporter of the Owatonna Today Show. We'd like to welcome you to the incubator. If you're a small business, whether you're existing or a startup, we can help you with office space, manufacturing or warehouse, and free confidential counseling.
Welcome to Bremer Bank. I am Jason Eiberg.
And I am Shannon Pedersen.
Bremer is a full financial services bank.
We invite you to stop by Bremer Bank and experience the Bremer difference.
You are always welcome at Bremer.
Hello, I'm David Einhaus with the Owatonna Foundation. Thank you to all of our donors who have helped make Owatonna a better place to live. Will you join us today with a financial gift? Owatonna Foundation is a proud sponsor of the Owatonna Today Show.
And we're back with Josh Archer from Express Employment and Professionals. How are you?
Good, how are
you? Did I say it right?
Absolutely.
Oh, good. Sometimes I never know. Yeah, it's one of those days. So Josh, we want to continue the conversation from a different viewpoint.
Sure.
So we were talking with the other two who were kind of trying to get information out about jobs, opportunities, and you actually have the jobs in your pocket.
Absolutely.
You're like handing them out like candy, aren't you?
Yes, absolutely.
So first of all, tell us, give us a little bit of information about yourself.
I am the business development manager for Express here in town in Owatonna, and I cover anywhere from Northfield down to Blooming Prairie to Waseca. Mm-hmm. That's my territory. Mm-hmm. So I am basically an opportunist. I go out and I create opportunities in the community for people to get back in the workforce or also with employers to find people for the workforce in the workplace.
Yeah, and so we were talking a little bit about the job, there's just an overflow of jobs right now.
Correct.
And the lack of employment. And so how do you as Express kind of get people who walk in the door prepared for a better job? Maybe they might be qualified for this, but they could actually do this job. How do you prepare an employee for that kind of opportunity?
Well, you know, I do want to say, you know, the training that we're provided from Express is really number one, and it's top of the line. So when they come in and they have a certain skill set or they've been doing this job for a while, what we do is we put it into our Q4 system, and we basically build a profile on that person. So when the employer is calling and saying, hey, I'm looking for a sales rep, or I'm looking for a assembler that needs this certain criteria, by building that profile of the person that's looking for a job or maybe looking for a better opportunity, based on those skill sets of the employer in our system that we've built that profile, we match them together, and then we can present them with the most qualified opportunity.
Well, what's great about it is sometimes it's a temporary job, but there are other times when it's actually for hire.
Absolutely.
So it's not just, I don't want people to think that Express is only, you know, just temporary.
Right.
Because actually it can go into a full-time long-term job.
Correct. Yeah. And our goal is to create those opportunities for people for full-time employment. Mm-hmm. As, you know, a lot of people have the old adage that, oh, Express or whatever company is a temporary agency, yeah. You know, and that's gone away, and we are a staffing agency.
Yeah.
So our goal is at that 90-day period, that evaluation period, so you can get to learn the company can get to learn you, make sure you're a good cultural fit, then they can roll over to their payroll mm-hmm. and become one of their full-time employees. Yeah. So it's really a stepping stone and an opportunity for, you know, all parties mm-hmm. to learn about each other.
Tell me about, just give me an idea of the type of jobs that someone might have when they walk into Express. Like, what opportunities do you have for people, different job opportunities?
Sure. You know, when they walk into Express, and typically we have anywhere from, you know, very entry-level positions starting at, you know, assembly, all the way up to, we do direct hires, we do executive searches. Mm-hmm. So we could go all the way up from assembly to CEO. Mm-hmm. And we do that throughout the year. So, I mean, based on the peaks and the valleys in production and the area, you know, a majority of our is somewhere in that range. I know it's very broad.
Yeah, it is.
And that's the purpose is because we're creating opportunities, not just for one specific group, but for everybody.
Right.
But our biggest challenge right now is really that two-year vocational schooling window where you have the welders, the machinists, more of that specialized trade.
That's where you're really looking for people.
That's the biggest need currently.
Yeah.
And the hardest and the most challenging to find.
Is it? Because yes. Because there's not maybe that many people going into that kind of educational situation?
Yep. Either A, they're going for a four-year degree, mm-hmm. which is great.
Yeah.
But also that skill set and that trade is kind of dying off mm-hmm. As the generation now that's been doing it for a while.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's going to come to an end, and it's going to come abruptly, mm-hmm. and that's kind of what we're seeing now. Is it's almost like the edge of the cliff,
yeah.
and then there's nobody replacing those skills. So they're either a lot of companies are doing, you know, on-the-job training, as they spoke about,
right.
And we're able to give them the opportunities and put them with the companies that are willing to train them too.
Oh, okay. Okay, so if maybe you have an interest in welding but you don't have that background, don't be afraid. Come in, talk
about
it, and you can even maybe find an opportunity to learn and train on that.
Absolutely.
Nice.
You know, if they have, you know, a strong work ethic and, you know, they have good attendance and they really want to work
mm-hmm.
and they have that mechanical aptitude mm-hmm. or any kind of, you know, the aptitude that they're looking for, we're not afraid to ask, you know. And that's what we're here for, is we're here to create opportunities. Because our goal is to enable everyone to be profitable, not just, you know, Express or the company, but also the associate we're placing needs to be profitable at the same
because
time.
Because if people who are coming to you are not being successful in their job searches, they're not going to come back.
Absolutely.
Or they're not going to tell other people, or it's going to kind of be a dry well for you. Which right now you need those employees.
Right. You know, and we're getting plenty of people, but, you know, as they spoke about too, is, you know, we're getting into a very busy season in Owatonna, as everybody knows, as far as production. So we have that peak right now and that ramp up time. So, you know, currently we have, you know, 30 to 50 openings right now. So
what do you do for those people who might be underemployed, who are doing a couple of jobs, you know, and because that's a big step, you know, to say, okay, I know I'm making it now. Do I really want to go and do something else where I don't know if I can make it? How do you help somebody transition from being underemployed to getting that job that they need and that actually feel fulfilled in?
You know, if they're currently making it now and they have the time, we will provide training for them. We have a Prove It system, which you can go online
mm-hmm.
and you can do evaluation. So if you want to worry, if you want to build your skills on Excel or Word or, you know, Office skills or on HIPAA or data, you know, security. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have those systems we can send to you, and you can do a tutorial and increase your scores. And as you increase your scores, we'll record them.
Wow.
So when you're really looking to make that transition and you're looking for typing 60 words a minute or data entry of 10,000 keystrokes, we have all that saved and we have all those things saved for them.
Yeah.
So we're able to present them to the employers that are looking for that skill set.
Okay.
So we have a lot of options out
there. So it sounds like, in a way, it's also a confidence-building situation for them.
Absolutely.
How do you have, so it seems like a lot of technical classes. Do you ever have classes for interpersonal working with people? Because, you know, in management levels, of course, it's a lot of more interpersonal situations.
Mm-hmm.
But do you do classes for that kind of situation as
well? We do. You know, we do put on, you know, we do summits throughout the year. We do a lot of seminars. We have a lot of stuff on our website that you can go to. We have some interactive programs. You know, and if they want to come in and really work on, and when they apply with us, we allow them to go through. It's a very formal interview. It's just like mm-hmm. any other job.
Mm-hmm.
So building that confidence, we'll give them feedback based on our interview, because at some point they're going to have to go meet the employer.
Yep.
So, you know, if there's something that they need to work on, we don't want them to go in without having any kind of feedback.
Yeah.
So then we're being counterproductive. So at the same token, we're going to give them the positive reinforcement they need
mm-hmm.
and that confidence booster mm-hmm. to go out there. And they're more than happy to come back. We'd love for them to come back. You know, if it doesn't work out, we'll find them something else and we'll keep working with them and helping them.
Especially, like you said, today, right now, it is a job seeker's market.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if someone's interested, they've heard today, everything from part-time to full-time. So if
absolutely.
Somebody wants part-time, what should they do? What's their first step?
First step is to come into our office here in Owatonna, or you can go online at Owatonna Express or expresspros.com. Make sure you choose Owatonna, fill an application, and we'll call you, and we'll invite you in for an interview.
Yeah, can you just get the role so I can?
Absolutely.
And what does it look like for Express coming up next couple months?
Just busy.
Busy?
Busy.
You do job markets and that kind of thing, too, job fairs.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah. We like to call them recruiting blitzes, recruiting events.
Yeah. Sounds good.
But absolutely, we have recruiting blitzes, recruiting events. We're always, 80% of our business comes from referrals.
Uh-huh.
We're seeing second and third generations coming through the same office, so that's kind of exciting. I know Betsy will be, she's very happy about that. So we're seeing sons and daughters of the people we placed 20 years ago, which is great. It's great for the community. Keeps people right here in Owatonna. So,
and if they have questions for you, because employers, because that's definitely what your wheelhouse is, talking to employers.
Correct.
And kind of giving them, how can they get a hold of you?
They can call the office, 507-455-3002. They can call the office, ask for me. I will more than happy give them a call back, set up a meeting, and we can talk.
Great. Thanks so much for your time today. Really appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you.
I think it was a good addition to what we were talking about earlier.
Absolutely. And just to throw in there, we do the boot program through United Way as well.
So the boot program, Express. Wow. Absolutely. Boots everywhere. Boots for everybody. All right. We'll be right back. Please stay with us.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Pete Connor. I'm here to say some things about an upcoming bicycle safety course that's going to be held here in Owatonna. It's called TS101. It'll be held on the 26th and 27th of September. It's for people who are riders or drivers of bicycles that want to learn more about bike safety, about bike rules, and about bike handling technique. If you have any interest, give me a call. I'm at 456-1099.
Hi, Warren Abraham, Abraham Consulting Technologies, your one-stop technology shop. We support the Owatonna Today Show.
Owatonna Public Utilities, real people, real reliable, real progress.
Making life a little easier day after day, taking pride in our community, listening to what you say, a voice you can talk to. We're growing with you.
And let's take a look at some of your community service announcements. It's a big weekend. You're going to want to get out and enjoy what's going on in Owatonna, including the amazing culture race is happening this Saturday from 10:30 a.m. to 4:30 at Wilson Elementary School. It is Culture Fest. Lots of great opportunities to try new foods, see new cultures. You can check out more information about exactly what's going on at culturefest.org, but it's a great time. It's going to be a lot of fun. And come celebrate as they open the first mile of trail. It's the new single track at Kaplan's, and find out how about future trail plans. It's September 27th, and that is from 1 to 5. And again, another great opportunity, another great event is the Masquerade Celebration, Celebration of Art and Music at the Owatonna Arts Center. It's $50 per person. It includes drink, masquerade mask, as well as appetizers. There is entertainment by Jimmy and the Band of Souls, and you can check them out also online. It's also featured artists of Whitley Thompson, and there are going to be prizes. 6 p.m. is cocktail, 7 p.m. is music, appetizers, and fun. It's a great opportunity that's coming up on Saturday. On Thursday, October 2nd, it's tailgating for petunias. It's going to be at the clubhouse patio at Brooktree. Help support the flower basket program and enjoy a great meal. It is suggested donation of $15, but it is Thursday, October 2nd from 5 to 7. And the Steele County Historical Society is pleased to announce their children's programming for Thursday, October 2nd at the History Center. It's History Detectives, and they'll meet at 9, and then they also have the regular programming. It's on Thursday of each month. Thank you so much for joining us here. We'll see you next week when we're talking with Harvest Fest and Habitat for Humanity at 9:29 p.m. tonight. It's officially the start of fall, so enjoy your fall. We'll see you later.